think I don't deserve to be the acting OIC. I hope you guys can cooperate with me.
I want to come with you and Mom to Canada. I just want us to try to be a family again.
Are you really leaving soon? When are you leaving?
Who's leaving?
Margaret, she'll continue her studies in Manila.
So you're leaving. You should have told me right away, so I would have been ready.
I promised Mr. Emile I'd have a stable job before we settled down. Your father, he just wants the best for you, and I'll help him give you that.
Pinang, reapply at the hospital when Mr. Emile is better, okay?
You left the hospital, Pinang?
I'll be able to go back anyway. I just need to reapply.
Sorry, I
didn't tell you earlier.
We're okay now, right? I don't want us to go our own ways when we're not okay.
Why can't I still do this?
Maybe you really need to get yourself checked, Dad.
I'm perfectly fine. You were just too insistent that we go to the hospital.
You should have listened to whatever she tells you. This wouldn't have happened to you if you...
Emilio, you're not alone in this problem. Just trust your family. Hand over the reins. That's why we have a family, right?
Margaret, hi.
Julian.
How is she?
She's a bit sad, but don't worry too much.
I'll take care of Pina.
Maybe she just needs to breathe a little bit.
I'll just take her home later, Nanny Marcy, so you guys can head home.
We'll be home soon. Take care.
Beebs, you don't have to feel bad. I'm sure Mr. Emile didn't mean what he said to you. He was taken aback, and he's also coping with his condition, right? It's not easy.
I know that Dad is having a hard time right now, and I really just want him to get better. But I don't know. Maybe I'm doing something wrong, and that's why it's taking so long.
Beebs, stop blaming yourself. You are a good nurse. You're the best daughter that any father can have.
Then why is it taking him so long to recover? I mean, it's been almost 2 weeks since Dad got home, but he hasn't been able to do the exercises right.
Maybe it's not just our bodies that need to fully recover, Pinang. Your mind, plus your heart, and pride as well. And maybe it's not just Mr. Emile who needs to recover. You do too, Beebs. You're all traumatized because of what happened. And maybe you worry too much about Mr. Emil's condition. Beebs, you're holding back because you almost lost him.
So what should I do?
You just need to rest and relax. You know, just try to find something that you're going to enjoy. You know, just stop worrying so much, okay? Trust your boyfriend. Come here.
Love, I'm sorry about the things I said earlier. Please talk to me.
It's your daughter you owe an apology to.
I'll say sorry to her. I just said it to you first.
Why are you so stubborn anyway?
I said I'm sorry.
Love. I know what you're going through right now is difficult. That's why everyone here is doing everything we can to help you. But you know, that doesn't mean we're going to indulge you all the time, do you understand me? Especially when we know you might get hurt, love.
I was just scared that I would sit on that wheelchair forever.
Why, love? Do you think I'll just allow that to happen? Or allow you to give up? Is that how you think I care for you and love you? You know, when Pinang called me earlier, I thought something really terrible had happened. I don't want to go through the heartache we went through when you got operated on, love. That will be the death of me.
Please don't talk like that.
Well, it's just because you're so stubborn.
I'm sorry, love.
Immensely stubborn.
You've said that 4 times now.
You want one more time? So you won't ever forget it, huh?
That's engraved in my heart. Right here. Along with the love you have for me. And that of our children. I'll never forget about that love.
Well, you really shouldn't. That's years worth of love. So don't you ever forget that, okay? Especially when you feel discouraged.
I never will. Yeah. Love. Can you please help me apologize to Pinang? Come on. Please.
All right.
Sir, this is the file you asked for.
Okay, great. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Phil, I need you to take a look at this. I know you guys have a lot on your plate with deadlines and everything, but Greeno Travels is one of our most valued and longtime clients. Right now, they're looking into expanding their services here in East Asia, and they need a really powerful mobile app to go with it. So, can I count on you? Together with your team? They need ideas for now, so I'm pretty confident you guys will come up with something really good. After all, you guys are our best app developers.
We'll do our best, sir.
Yes, thanks.
Babe, tell Pinang not to worry about Mr. Emil too much.
You're the one who shouldn't worry, babe.
I don't want her to get angry with Mr. Emil, because I know how much those two love each other.
Like you and your dad, huh?
Honestly, babe, when I decided to go with him abroad and finally give Dad a second chance, it suddenly seemed easier to love him.
Well, of course you wanted to forgive him already.
And of course you're good at convincing people.
Of course. I know what will make my babe happy.
Babe? Dad is already processing my papers and my visa. And when they arrive, I'll be leaving.
We're ready for this, right?
Cheek.
No, I know that.
when I get home, I'll sob, I'll cry my heart out, so I made an advance. A combination of three things. One last. It's all right. Don't cry. Don't cry.
Mr. Emil?
Good morning.
Good morning to you, too.
How are you? May I ask why you're calling?
I'm okay. So are you busy today?
Well, it's Sunday.
I'm currently out. Just bought some stuff in San Fernando.
After that, I was planning to go see Pinang.
That's exactly why I called you today. I want to ask for your help regarding Pinang.
Okay. Anything for you?
Phil?
Hello? Miki?
Listen, let's go to Pinang's place together.
Oh, okay. I'm at the street corner near my house. Nars is with me, too.
All right. I'll pick you guys up.
What about,
Doc JM? Did he confirm?
Yes, he said he's on his way. Hold on! What are we doing at Pinang's?
Well, Mr. Emil has a plan.
Okay, all right. See you.
Here, Mom.
Mom, I'll just buy Dad's medicines at the pharmacy.
Okay, Pinang.
Dad.
Hello!
Hi!
Hello,
hello, ladies and gentlemen!
Hi, Mr. Emil.
Good
What's
morning.
What's going on?
Mr.
What's up?
Hi, Mr. Apple.
Hey, hold on. What are you guys doing here?
We are going on a field trip.
Oh, no, I can't join you. I can't leave Dad.
That's why we're here. Doc JM, Nars, and I are going to substitute for you in watching over Mr. Emil.
Oh, but it's my turn to work at the eatery.
I fixed your schedule on our duty chart. It's okay.
Mackie and I will take care of it. You know that we have a lot of fans waiting over there for us every day.
I packed your bag, too.
Dad, tell me, are you still mad at me? Don't you want me to be your nurse anymore, and is that why you asked the others to take care of you?
Of course not. This is just your day off. Then after that, you're going back to your duty with me. You're always by my side. I'm afraid we might switch faces in the long run.
Yikes.
You don't want that, do you?
Come on, Dad. So you're not mad anymore?
Why would I be mad? You're overprotective towards me because you love me so much. Who would get mad about that? I should actually be thankful, but you might be mad at me, Pina.
No, Dad, never. Promise.
Pina, I know the extent of the sacrifice you're doing for me. Believe me, not just you, but your brothers too. I want to thank you and I also want to apologize about what I said yesterday. I'm sorry. You know, we oldies tend to be like that. We become too impatient.
Goodness. Oh, come on, Dad. You are not that old.
That's what I said. Well, let's just say I'm getting on in years. I don't want to admit it. But honestly, I do need your help now.
Dad. We're always here for you. Just say the word.
He's right. Just one call and we'll come running to your side, Dad.
Aw, how sweet!
Hug me instead, Miki.
But he was about to do it. He extended his arm, didn't he?
Mr. Apple.
All right, I'll just hug Mr. Apple instead.
Whoops. I was just joking, Doc. I might lose my job.
Bibbs, what are we doing here?
Because Mr. Emil knows you miss your job at the hospital. That's why he told me to bring you here. So here we are. And so you won't forget there's work waiting for you on your return. Get ready.
Nurse Pinang, welcome back.
Oh, thank you.
Well, are you ready to go on duty today?
Yes, I am.
That's good.
Thank you.
Here we are!
Oh, great! Let's go!
Mr. Emil!
Hello, Doc.
How are you? Are you ready for your therapy session today?
Oh.
Are you sure, Mr. Emil?
You're
really
sure about
sure?
this, huh?
Nice, you're staying
yay!
Positive. Nice.
Let's go!
Let's go!
Here we go!
Let's go.
Come on, let's go!
Where is that?
Sir, your BP is quite high. It's 200 over 140. Do you really have high blood pressure?
Yes.
Do you have any medication?
Too expensive. If it were up to me, I'd want to get a stroke to see my late wife in the afterlife.
Oh, no, don't say that, sir. Please don't be selfish. What about the children you'll leave behind? They'll be sad without you. And they're going to miss you for sure, sir. They might develop high blood pressure. Do you want that?
At least my dad listens to you. I don't know what to do anymore, nurse. He can be so stubborn.
Well, maybe it would actually help your dad if you let him help you with the household work. You know, simple tasks that he can do, something small. So he won't get so bored while he's staying at home, right? You see, sir? Just by coming here, you've already done something good. You gave me an idea for my dad's recovery.
I did.
That's right. So please, don't be in a hurry to join your late wife yet. A lot of people love you and care about you. Just smile.
Babe, sit down. I'll make a snack for you.
There's no space, babe.
Stay here instead.
Stay here. Oh, babe, do you think you have extra space in your luggage?
It depends on what you want me to carry.
Well, I was hoping you could take my heart with you because there's no use keeping it here.
Oh, Mackie, you're so corny.
No, it's true. My heart only beats for you. Since you're leaving, what's the point? Just take it with you.
Oh, wow. But, babe, I'll really miss that about you.
What? My heart?
Your corny jokes.
I thought you wanted to take it with you.
Lutlut.
Sir.
Dear, I have good news. Listen, I just came from the Canadian embassy. Your visa will be released in 2 days.
Oh, thank you, Dad.
Mackie, thank you too.
Yes, sir.
I'll leave you too. I'll just go to your mom and give her the good news.
Okay.
Excuse me, Mackie.
Listen, Barbie doll. Even if you are leaving, I'm still happy because you and your dad are getting along. I just hope that you can strengthen the bond you two have.
But babe, you'll wait for me, right?
Of course, I'll wait for you. Besides, I don't want to plan our wedding on my own, babe. I'll be too lonely. Love you, babe.
I love you, babe.
What exactly are you feeling, ma'am?
I feel dizzy.
You feel dizzy? Oh, my. I'll just take your blood pressure, okay?
All right.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
You did it! There you go. Put your slippers on.
I'm enjoying the feeling of being sick now. It feels so nice to be cared for, especially by someone you love. I was thinking about settling down, having kids. I promised Mr. Emil I'd have a stable job before we settled down. I'll have a house for our future family. Your father, he just wants the best for you. And I'll help him, Binan. I'll help him give you that.
All set?
Careful.
Okay, ready?
Are you okay, Mr. Emil? You're not in pain?
Comfortable,
not really.
Mr. Emil?
Yes, it's fine.
Okay, don't you want to eat? Mrs. Marcy's cooking is really good.
Yes, do you want to eat inside your room? We can bring the food in here.
I'll just eat later. I'm still full.
Pinong and I will eat together when she and Phil come home.
Oh, okay. Go on and rest, Mr. Emil. But just in case you get hungry, just tell us.
Would you please hand over my guitar? I won't get that bored.
Can you play the guitar now, Mr. Emil?
Here, do you need help, Mr. Emil?
Yeah. No. I'll just hold my guitar and pretend I can still play it.
You still can, Mr. Emil. Just have faith.
It's okay, Doc. I know there are a lot of things I can't do. I think I'm feeling this way because I still can't accept it. Maybe I should learn to accept things as they are. There are still a lot of things I can do.
Okay, Mr. Emil, we'll leave you to rest.
Thank you, okay?
We'll go outside first, okay? Excuse us, Mr. Emil.
Just call us.
Need your strength. Rest first, Mr. Emil. Excuse us.
We have bananas here.
Oh,
come on, have some.
Thank you, Mr.
Emil.
Thank you. I'm in a coffee commercial.
Ooh, let's try this.
I'll try it.
There you go.
Try this banana.
Oh, hey.
Oh, it's a good thing you remembered about
that. Welcome to my joke.
So how was your field trip?
Well, it was lots of fun. I mean, I really missed going on duty as a nurse.
See, Bina? To think you were trying to say no earlier,
It's not that I didn't want to. It's just difficult to leave Dad.
Mm-hmm.
By the way, how is he, Doc?
He was fine. He was well-behaved. He's resting in his room right now.
Pinang, go see him because he's been waiting for you. He's even asked us to give him his guitar. He's in a sentimental mood. For sure.
Okay, excuse me while I check on him. Thanks for all your help.
No.
Okay, I'll just check on him.
Mr. Opera's busy.
Thanks for doing this. Especially you, Doc. I know how busy you are.
It's nothing. Not for friends.
I'm very lucky to have friends like you guys.
Of course.
Oh, you know, Phil.
What's
so nice, Phil.
What's that?
I'm your friend too, right?
Oh, no. Listen,
this is
no,
nice
leave
romance.
Back off. Get out of there. Move. Listen, guys, listen. I'm so lucky to have friends like you.
Oh, yeah.
Right, Nars? Hey, you're my best friend,
oh, really,
right?
No.
Hold on.
Can you take a picture of us?
That's it.
Why am I taking
so we're
your
all
mom?
The same height.
Oh, Mr. Okay. Apple. We're ready for a picture.
What am I supposed
take a picture
to do
of
with
us,
that?
Mr. Apple. Go, you can do it. Yes, yes.
Go, go, go,
go.
Doc.
Smile.
You got
oh,
it?
Yay.
Oh, wow.
Let me see. Oh, hey, what happened? Huh?
This is you, Mr. Apple.
You
yes,
help
that's me.
Hello, Dad.
Wow.
Oh, wait a minute. Excuse me. All right. So what song are you playing?
Pinang, please forgive your father, okay? This is just temporary. I promise it will pass soon enough. Just a little more patience for me. I promise you that.
Oh, Dad. You can be grumpy every day if you want to. That's okay with me. I love you very much. Oh, no, I knew it. One more time, Dad. Go.
Thank you.
Beebs, here's your coffee.
Thank you, Beebs.
It's good.
Delicious, huh?
It is. Listen, Beebs. One day, I want to learn how to play this guitar. Just like how Mr. Mill plays. Maybe I'll ask him to teach me when he gets better. I want to serenade you every single day.
Every single day? Well, okay, but you might run out of songs then.
And I want to learn all the songs that you love.
Bibbs, thank you. Because I know that you also have a lot of problems at work, but here you are with me, and you still have time for me.
It's nothing, Beebs. And don't worry. When I've fixed my problem at the office, I'll have more time for you.
So you guys aren't getting along yet? Really? Well, what if you and your team go on a team-building seminar? Go somewhere where you won't think of work or anything. Just have fun. Remember what you did for me? Or there might be something else that you could do, like...
Beebs, football!
Hey, that's a good idea. That should do it. You can do it here in San Isidro or anywhere around, really.
You see? You should be the OIC. You have great ideas.
I just want to help you out, that's all. Because you've been by my side all this time. And by my family's side these past few weeks. So I want to do the same for you. I'll give you my full support as long as you need it.
Just like a team?
A team.
So, what do you think, sir? Do you think you can give us at least one more day for our team-building activity? I'm pretty confident that after this, our team will be more efficient and productive, sir.
Okay, I'll approve this. But you have to assure me, Phil, this will not be the cause of delay of our project's deadlines.
Yes, sir. I promise.
And thank you for taking the initiative. Our company really needs somebody like you.
Okay. Thank you. Excuse me.
I've noticed there's been a delay in the return of Mr. Emil's motor skills, although honestly, we really should have regular exercises for him.
That's what I was gonna consult with you. I was thinking maybe we could change my dad's exercises. Maybe we can consider something more productive and more familiar to him. I actually have a list, Doctor. These are several exercises that he can do, if that's okay with you. Mom? Hi, Dad. How are you? Oh, wow. You did all of that, Dad?
A bit. There. My grip is getting stronger. I can almost curl my fingers into a fist. Look.
Well, that's really good, Dad. Hold on. Aren't you tired yet?
I can manage. I've only just started anyway.
Oh, he was able to do that all easily. Look, he didn't even break a sweat.
Well, that's really good. Okay, let's put these aside.
Hold on. I can still do more.
Oh, yes, Dad. That's why I'm going to teach you a new exercise.
Ah, that sounds good.
You will work as therapy.
What's that?
Well, you wanted to help out at the eatery, isn't that right? Well, this is very simple, Dad. While Mom and I are cutting the ingredients, you're going to shred it and put it in the container. There's a reason for that. The act of shredding simulates exercises that we do for grip and flexibility. So you're not only doing your therapy, you're also working. Oh, Mom, can you please tell Julian and Mackie we have a new assistant at our eatery?
They better watch out. Once I work there, I'll be the most handsome man to work there.
What's new? The usual. So late. Hello. What took you so long?
Well, finally, since we're all here, let's get started. I've called this meeting to discuss about two very important announcements. First, we'll be working on this new project called the Greeno Travels. I know that we're very busy here with our workload, but according to Mr. De Castro, he ordered us to present ideas for the new GT Mobile app.
Wow. Overtime again. Great.
Don't worry about it. Mr. De Castro assured me that he will be giving us incentives.
Wow, cool. That's nice.
And my second announcement, before we start working on this project, we will be having a team activity.
Hey, cool. Like an outing? Out of town? Like an outdoor team building?
Something like that.
Nice. Okay.
Okay. Okay.
Wow, we sure have a lot of time.
It's nice, a change of scenery instead of seeing all this plastic. Oh, did I say plastic?
Computer.
Oh, sorry, I meant computers.
Leo's right.
I promise, you'll enjoy yourselves.
Yes.
Yeah. This is going to be fun.
Yes, fresh
air. New.
Margaret? Margaret?
Come in.
Come eat. The food is ready downstairs.
It's okay, Nanny. I don't have an appetite.
You've been here since earlier. Wait a minute. Are you sick?
It's Mommy. Why did she make me come back here just to leave me alone?
Don't be sad. Your debut is coming up, right? All your friends will come. You'll get to see them, so cheer up.
Nanny, listen. All my friends are from San Isidro. How will they come in here?
Wow. This son of mine likes to help out at the eatery too much.
Well, it's better to be busy than to be sad, Mom.
You miss her, huh?
I really do. But it's all right. Her birthday is coming up.
Hold on. Do you have something to wear? Should I sew something or buy a suit?
Mom, I don't even know if I'm invited yet. But I'll probably send my present over to her.
Come on, Julian. Take it to her. I'll give you a day off.
Really?
Do you have a gift? Have you thought of something?
Not yet, Mom, but maybe something cheap so I can afford it.
I'll give you extra money. I was really planning on giving you a salary for always helping out at the eatery.
No need, Mom. The work that I do at that place is for our family, so you don't need to pay me. Besides, it doesn't matter if the gift isn't expensive, right? What matters is it comes from the heart.
So ask your father for suggestions. He's an expert at that.
Okay, Mom?
Pinang.
Oh. Hello, Pinang. We're going to the eatery, okay? So we can keep Elsa company.
Okay, but don't forget our surprise for Dad.
We won't.
Goodbye, take care.
Bye. Let's go, Mom.
All right.
Miss, may I have a drink of water? Just one glass. Oh, thank you. You can take that. Hey, Mackie.
Hey.
Hey. Thank you.
You're all dressed up. Going on a date.
Nice, looking good.
Nice shirt.
Well, yes, of course. I need to look handsome for Lotlot, since she's about to leave.
Oh.
Look at him. Maybe he dressed up on purpose so she won't leave.
Right.
That's the way it is. Well, all good? I look okay?
Don't worry.
Great,
you look
bro.
Good. Good luck.
I'll go ahead, man.
Take care.
Take care.
Are those letters from your students?
Yes.
You'll miss them, huh? And I'm sure you'll miss teaching, too.
Of course.
Hold on. Why don't you try teaching there instead? I didn't realize we had a lot of pictures. Was this our anniversary?
Yes. We even argued that day.
It's a good thing you forgave me then.
Because I love you, Mackie.
Hey, so all this, take it with you, babe. So that you won't forget me wherever you go, okay?
Okay.
Babe?
Hmm?
What if I just stay here?
Babe. Listen, the sadness we feel right now will probably fade away after a while because you'll feel much happier when you're living with your parents. It's still a different feeling when your family's whole. I want you to experience that. So that when the time comes that we're ready to start our own family, we can share it with them, the happiness we felt. We can let them experience it.
Thank you for coming with me, Bibbs. The surprise for Dad is really important.
Anything for you, Bibbs.
Thank you.
And for Mr. Emil.
Where's Mr. Badong? Oh, there he is.
Binang.
Hey!
Emil.
Oh, Badong.
What happened to your voice?
It's really like this. When it's cold out, Binang. You had something important to tell me?
Oh, that's right. I just wanted to ask you for a small favor. For the planting tomorrow, it's a surprise for Dad.
Surprise? Wow, I like surprises.
Hello, Marga. I know what theme will work for your debut. Something fit for a princess.
Well, a princess gets everything she wants.
I don't.
Maybe not right now, but maybe someday. So, just stay positive.
I don't know.
I don't feel excited about my debut. You guys are miles away.
Listen, no matter where you have it, even if it's Mars or Pluto, if you tell me to come, then I'll be there.
You will?
Of course.
My princess can't do without a prince now, can she?
The prince of persistence and corny jokes.
That's what I'm good at. Hey, I miss that.
What?
Your laugh.
Don't feel sad.
It doesn't suit you. What's better is us together.
Ha ha.
Hey, that was a pity laugh, Margaret.
But it's okay.
As long as you're always happy.
Jillian, thank you.
Anything for you.
Good morning, love.
Good morning. You've been awake long?
A little. The farmers are going to start planting later. Pinang and I are going to prepare breakfast for them.
Wow. You're so kind and hardworking. I'm so inspired.
It's more inspiring to see you smile like this.
Good morning, Mom. Grandpa.
Good morning, Emil. You're up early today.
Can you believe it, Father? He even woke up before me. You want coffee?
Yes, thanks. Wait. Where are your sister and brother?
Mom!
Hey, good morning!
Good morning!
Good morning! Surprise!
Dad!
What's that for?
Hold on, you're going to see Dad. Whoops!
What's that?
We're gonna get off here, Mr. Carabao.
Great, wait.
There you go, Dad. This is for you.
Thank you. I'll give it to them now.
Good morning. Good morning. Good morning.
Sir, my team and I can't make it tomorrow, so good luck on your team building. And, can you please sign our leave forms?
I'm sorry, Hannah, but I can't sign this.
Why not?
Because everyone is required to attend our team activity tomorrow.
I still have another event to go to. And I really can't go. Them too.
Well, in this case, it's best to talk to HR. This is funded and required by the company.
Thank you.
Okay.
I hate this.
You heard that?
Yes.
That'll do.
There you go. Make sure that it's locked in place,
there,
okay?
That'll do.
Great.
All right.
Will this support us all?
Oh, Dad, just relax. That's really sturdy.
Pretty solid.
As solid as our support for you, Sir Emil.
It's true. We made this, Sir Emil.
Well, now I'm more nervous.
To put your mind at ease, Dad, just smile. And because of that, let's take a picture first.
Okay.
I'll stay here.
Picture.
All right, then. We'll take three pictures, okay? First, we'll take a normal picture. One, two, three. One more. One, two, three. And now a goofy pose. Come on.
Hey,
one, two,
said
three.
Goofy.
Wish you were here, Bibbs.
Just smile and have fun.
Hey, Dad looks really excited right now.
Dad, give me your hand. Hold this.
I'll scatter seeds, too.
Whoops, be careful.
Do you think I can do it? You sure? The seeds might go to waste.
That'll be a piece of cake for you. And besides, Phil said to just smile and have fun.
Okay, so
smile and have fun.
Let's go.
All right, let's get moving.
Here we go.
Okay, stand behind Dad.
Set.
I can't go without
coming. Make sure you hold on tight, Julian. Be careful. No messing
around.
Does it
look good?
It's
let's
perfect.
Go.
Let's go.
Hold on to your father, Ma. Goodbye, Grandma.
Bye, Ma.
Bye. Careful. Hold on tight. Watch your father.
I'm fine. Don't worry.
All right.
Let's go. Let's go, everyone.
Let's go.
Guitar to play the chords.
Bye now.
Seedlings any good?
Our seedlings will be huge and bountiful, I just know it! Right, everyone? Yeah! 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 Oh, we'll have a bountiful harvest!
I missed this.
Oh, Dad, you know what? I think that this is going to be the best therapy for you.
Thank you, Pina. Thank you for your patience and confidence in me. Thank you for not giving up on me.
Oh, come on. Giving up isn't part of our vocabulary, remember? We should always fight, fight, fight.
That's why you're my favorite child.
Oh, no.
I mean, favorite daughter.
Good. Thanks for clearing things up.
Well, can you all see it?
See what?
The new rice seedlings!
And renewed hope!
Here it is!
Let's go, Dad!
Let's have some more.
Hey, bro, what's your plan, by the way, for tomorrow?
Oh, right. I'm excited. This is the first time this has happened here.
We will be doing something that I learned from Pina.
All right,
it's going to be fun. Just wear something comfortable.
Something you learned from Pina?
Yes, that's right. So wear comfortable clothes.
Okay.
How are you feeling, Dad?
I'm feeling great, Pina. With the way we're going, I'll be sure to recover fast.
Okay, just get some rest for now. I already asked Julian and Mackie to get us some snacks.
Snacks?
Yes, for the farmers, too. Oh, here they come.
Pina, here. Hey! Everyone, come on! Here. Stop working!
Let's go!
Let's have some snacks!
Let's go, everyone! Let's have a snack! Hurry! What do you want, Dad?
I want a banana!
Let's have some snacks first. Everyone, Mackie. We'll have
have more energy to work.
You know, Bib's dad looked so happy earlier. He's behaving a lot like he used to.
I wish I was there so I could see how happy you were.
Well, I want you to know that I'm just as happy when I'm with you.
Then I'll just stay by your side.
Oh, by the way, if you have some free time this weekend, maybe we can go out on a date? Dad and I are just going to the hospital, and then after that, I'm free the whole day.
Date night?
Your night. I mean, you're always taking care of me, so now it's your turn.
Game.
Well, aren't you going home yet?
You're making me leave?
No, I just don't want you staying up late.
Biebs, don't worry. I'm going home. I have to, because I still have to work.
Okay, come on, let's go.
Biebs, sit down. I'll stay a bit. 3 minutes tops. I promise.